Hello, my name is Katelyn Moore, and together with Dr. Natasha Rayne, I did an incubation study on the effect of biochar on available nutrients in a sandy loam soil, which took place at the University of Wisconsin River Falls greenhouse. For each treatment in this study, we looked at the percent of organic matter, cation exchange capacity, pH, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, and magnesium. As a result, we found some interesting trends. Organic matter content throughout the study stayed relatively stable at around 4%. 14 days after biochar application, there was also no difference in cation exchange capacity between treatments, which consisted of the control of 0% biochar, 1.25% biochar, 2.5% biochar, and 5% biochar. However, at 28 days after the addition of biochar, cation exchange capacity decreased relative to 14 days after the addition of biochar. These results can be seen in tables 2 and 3. The pH of the soil did show statistical differences among treatments, with an increasing trend that correlated with increasing rates of biochar for both sampling periods, which were 14 days and 28 days after the biochar application. But there was no statistical difference between treatments with 2.5% biochar and 5% biochar at the 14-day sample. These results are shown in Figure 3 and are consistent with other studies, such as the study done by Laird et al., published in 2010, which found that when biochar was added to a clarion loam, it increased the soil's pH. We also had some interesting observations pertaining to the soil nutrients of potassium, calcium, magnesium, and phosphorus. As the rate of biochar increased, an increasing trend can be seen for potassium. This was the case for both the 14-day and 28-day sample. Calcium and magnesium, on the other hand, decreased as the rate of biochar increased 14 days after biochar was applied. However, after 28 days, the results for calcium and magnesium were inconsistent with the results observed 14 days after biochar application. These results can be seen in tables 2 and 3. Overall, we found a declining trend in phosphorus levels for both the 14-day and 28-day samples. At the 14-day mark, there was no statistical difference for the 2.5% and 5% biochar treatments. These results, which appear in Figure 4, seem to indicate that biochar immobilizes phosphorus in the soil. However, more research should be done on this. For this study, two more data sets will be taken, one 42 days after biochar application and one 56 days after application. By understanding the effect of biochar on the nutrient retention capabilities of soil in a greenhouse setting, this will enable a field study to be conducted in the future. Ultimately, this could have significant impacts on the economic and environmental sustainability of farming. Thank you for listening.